Would you like to enhance your live streaming web application with real-time overlay text, images, and even QR codes? Hey everyone, this is Hector from WebRTC Ventures, and in today's video, we will explore the fascinating world of insertable streams and WebCodecs API to learn how to build a dynamic live video processing pipeline. Let's dive into it. Before we jump into the code, let's quickly go over the technologies we will be using. First, we will leverage the Insertable Streams for Media Track API to manipulate video tracks in real time. Then, we will make use of the Video Frame interface from the WebCodecs API to create the video frames for these tracks. The goal is to build a complete live video processing pipeline, and we will start with the base broadcasting application that we will gradually enhance it to enable video frame manipulation. By the end, we should be able to add text, images, and even QR codes to our video frames, which will open a world of possibilities for interactive broadcasting. First, let's get familiar with the base application, which we can download from GitHub. Once it finishes, we can CD into the folder that we have just downloaded. Now, in order to code along, we need to check out into the code along branch. And next, we need to install the dependencies so that we can run it locally. And finally, we start the application by running the server.js script. Okay, now let's open a browser and head over to localhost 3000 and presenter.html, which is the file where we have the presenter's view. So let's wait a couple of seconds, and here we are. We are a presenter right now, so let's open a new tab. Head over, same to localhost 3000, and now to viewer. Let's click on join, and now we're seeing presenter's stream. So we can duplicate so that we can add another viewer. Again, we can join, and we're seeing presenter's view. We can chat, we can interact with the presenter using the chat and also with the other viewers. Let's add hello. Here we are, hello there. And as a presenter, we can also reply. Okay. So this is the base application. Next, we need to create a new file under public, and we will name this file track.urils.js. And in here, the first thing we need to do is to create a new function, one that returns a processed track that will contain all the manipulations that we want to add. So we create the function, and in the function, we receive two parameters, a track and a transform function. We create our track processor and track generator from Insertable Streams API. We also create a new transform stream where we pass the transform function as a parameter, and then we take processor's readable attribute and we pipe through the transformer object, and finally we deliver it into generator's writable property. Finally, we return the track generator. Now we need to create a transform function. This function receives two parameters, a video frame and a controller. And the idea is to process the video frames one at a time, applying the desired manipulations, and then add them to the controller's queue in order to create a new processed track. The function's content will be different based on the desired effect, and we aim to have the flexibility to change it dynamically. So to simplify this process, we will use a transform function factory that will create a custom transform function each time. So let's start with the very minimal transform function, where we simply pass the current video frame onto the controller without any modifications. We will use this one to clear out any other processing we make. And the next step is to add our newly created live video processing pipeline to the presenter's view. To do so, let's start by adding the newly created script like this. So I add the script tag, I add the track utils script, and I close the tag. Next, We will add a variable here called transformFN that will be used to store the selected transform function. And finally, we need to modify the handler for getUserMedia. The first thing we need to do is to assign a transform function from the transform function factory, in this case, clean stream. And then we will create a new constant for our processed track. So I will name this ptrack, and here we will call create processed track. Remember that we need to send two parameters. One is the track that we want to modify, and we get this from the stream. So we call get video tracks, and we get the first one available. And next, we need to send a transform function. So the trick here is to pass the video track acquired from getUserMedia along with the transform function we get from the transform function factory. We achieve this by using an arrow function like this. We get the video frame and also a controller. And then we simply call whatever is stored in the transformFN variable and pass the required parameters, so frame and controller. Next, we create a new media stream. Using the processed track that we have just created. Now, let's check the application. So we go to localhost 3000 and presenters view. And while it seems like nothing is going on, our live video processing pipeline is running under the hood. To make things more interesting, let's add a way for a presenter to display text announcements over the video. To do so, we will create a new transform function factory that sets up the necessary components and provides the required transform function. This function will combine the video stream with the moving text overlay and render the final result in an off-screen canvas, which is then used to create a new video frame using WebCodecs API's video frame interface. So our new function looks like this. We add some parameters to allow customizations, and we also add some default values. Then we initialize the off-screen canvas, and we get the 2D context from it. Then we initialize some values for the text position. And finally, we get the actual transform function that will be returned from this factory. As usual, we have the frame and the controller parameters, and start by setting the right width and height for the canvas. Next, based on the value of the parameters, we set the position for the text and we render all the required elements. Finally, we make sure that after the text has left the screen, we make it appear again. We create a new video frame, close the current one, and queue the new one onto the controller. The next step is to call this new transform function from the UI and update the value of the transformFN variable, so the pipeline processes the video track accordingly. In the UI side, let's add a couple of new elements. First, an input that will allow the user to write the announcement. Then, an announce button that will show the message in the video, and a clear button that will clear up the effect. We also need to get the elements and also add proper event listeners for each of these events. Now let's just align these correctly and let's check our application once again. So we go to localhost 3000, presenter, and there we have our presenter's view. Now we have two extra elements in the screen, so I will add an announcement. Hello there, click on announce, and see how we have an overlay text on top of the video. Now let's clear it up. We go back to the initial effect. Let's now introduce a new feature to our pipeline, the ability to overlay images onto the video stream. To achieve this, again, we will create a transform function factory, only that this time we will leverage the file API to read an image provided by the user and then utilize an off-screen canvas to combine all the elements. So we create a new function. Again, we add some parameters for customization. We initialize our off-screen canvas, we get the 2D context from it, and now we read an image using File API. In the actual function, we set the right width and height for the off-screen canvas, we clear out the content of the canvas, we draw the frame, and we draw the image on top of it. We get the timestamp, and we close the current frame. Then, same as before, we use WebCodecs API's video frame interface for creating a new video frame from the content of the canvas, and we add it to the controller. Now, we go back to the presenter's view and add a new HTML element, this time an input that allows the user to add an image. Then, we get the element using its ID and add a proper event listener. We format this, and same as before, all we need to do is simply update the value of the transformFN variable by calling the new transform function factory. Again, let's take a look at the application. So we go to localhost, presenter, and now let's choose a file. Let's use this one. Click on open. And there we have, it's here, an image showing on top of our video. This new superpower feels great, doesn't it? What other kind of live video processing can you think of? What about QR codes? These are a convenient way to share information with others, and we can use our pipeline to easily add them to our application. To do so, we need a way to generate a QR code in the first place. So let's add the QRcode.js QR code generator library to the code. This is as simple as adding a new script into the presenter's view. Then, let's create a new transform function factory. It will be similar to the one we created for adding images, only that instead of reading an image, we will generate a new QR code using the third-party library we just added. So, our new transform function factory will look like this. Again, we add some parameters for customization, we initialize our off-screen canvas, and now we create a new div element, where the QR code is going to be rendered. We create the QR code using the syntax required by the third-party library, and then inside the actual transform function, again, we set the right width and height for the off-screen canvas, we clear up the content of the canvas, we draw the frame, and then we draw the QR code we just created. We get the timestamp from the frame, we close the current one, we create a new one, and we queue it to the controller. In the presenter's view, let's reuse the announcement text input we added before and simply add an additional button for generating a QR code. Same as before, we get the HTML element using its ID and add a proper event listener where we simply update the content of the transformFN variable. Now let's open the application once again by going to localhost 3000, presenter, and we add some text for the QR code. Hello there. Click on Make QR. And there we have our new QR code. In conclusion, we explored the powerful capabilities of live video processing pipelines for WebRTC applications using Insertable Streams and WebCodecs API. By leveraging these technologies, we were able to create dynamic video experiences by adding text overlays, images, and QR codes in real time. We applied the concept of transform function to seamlessly manipulate video streams, which opens endless possibilities for enhancing live video communication. If you're looking to integrate live video processing into video conferencing, live streaming, or any other WebRTC-based application, at WebRTC Ventures, we are experts at building high-quality, real-time communication apps using WebRTC. Contact us to know more about our services at webrtc.ventures/contact. Be sure to follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn as WebRTC Ventures and WebRTC.ventures. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more WebRTC tips. Let's make it live!